That is very pretty.
So we're going to put some sodium into liquid ammonium. So what happens is that the sodium reacts, it releases an electron, becomes sodium single plus, and those electrons get solvated by the ammonia. And that's a really unusual thing in chemistry, to have just electrons themselves being solvated.
Here we have a Dewar. This is just like you put a thermos flask or something, you put your cold drink or hot tea in. And in it we've got some solid CO2, cardose, and acetone. So that brings the whole temperature down to about minus 78. And we need to do that because ammonia boils at minus 33 degrees. So we've got ammonia in this cylinder over here. We've just condensed some of that into this sealed tube, which currently is not sealed, but we're using this because it's got nice thick glass. So as we put the sodium in, you'll see that blue colour forming. It'll obviously heat up because there's some solvation going on, some heat of solvation. So we'll have to dunk it back into the cold bath just to stop all the ammonia from boiling off. So we've got cut some sodium up. We had a big lump of sodium, cut some bits off that, and we're going to put smaller chunks in. This is going to go in there, and hopefully it will not be too vigorous a reaction. There you go. So you can see that blue colour already forming as the sodium reacts with the liquid ammonia. So it's going a nice deep blue colour. I'll just dip that back in to keep it cold.
Wow, it's like ink.
Yeah, yeah. So the sodium wants to lose an electron, wants to be sodium plus. It's much happier being sodium plus. And so it's releasing those electrons into the ammonia solution. They're being solvated, which is why I get this intense blue colour. It's that solvation complex. So if we get the concentration of electrons high enough, then it changes colour again. It goes to a sort of metallic colour. So we need to add in a reasonable amount of sodium to get that to happen. And what will happen is that the ammonia with all the electrons in, that's slightly more dense, and so that separates out from just ammonia, and you'll get two layers, and you'll get a sort of metallic-y bronze sort of coloured layer. Put some more sodium in there, and you can hear it fizzing as it reacts. So we've got a really, really intense blue colour now. Almost looks black, so let's put that in there. I would have thought that would be enough, but you never know. See, we're already starting to see some of that bronze on the surface. Okay, so we've added some more sodium. We've gone from very deep blue to almost black. We're starting to see some signs of this metallic sheen, but we don't really want to put too much of that on, because otherwise we'll boil all our. So we're trying to get the molarity of the electrons in solution to a certain point where we get a separation of the layers. We get the solvated electrons will look sort of metallic-y, and the rest of it will look, well, we'll see what it looks like.
Oh yeah, now it's
well, we're reacting the sodium with the isopropanol. So now we're making sodium isopropoxide. So all the electrons will be reacting away. Again, we'll get hydrogen gas in there. A bit more. So we're getting this sort of grey sodium isopropoxide.
It's an ugly old thing, that.
Solution, yeah, it looks like an experiment gone wrong at the moment. It's not, it's doing what it should do. It's making everything safe so that we can dispose of it. The last remnants of this metallic solution here.
Yeah, it looks metallic still.
Looks, yeah. There's a lot of electrons in there. We put quite a lot of sodium in there.
these electrons that are in there, they're free, are they? They're just like roaming?
They're solvated, so the ammonia, there are many ammonias around the electrons. And at a certain concentration, the electrons reflect the light, and you can see it as this sort of metallic solution. The electrons are getting less concentrated in this bit down here, more concentrated up here where they're reacting. See some nice flow going on. I'll put that down before it goes all over my gloves.
Yeah, it's flowing up.
Yeah. A liquid metal. Unlike mercury, it's not silvery coloured, it's gold coloured, or bronze coloured.
So what's the blue and the coppery? What's happening there?
It's different concentrations of electrons in solution. That's the only difference.
Look at that, that's the separation we were looking for.
Yeah, that's right.
No.
So the goldy coloured bit has more electrons and the blue less. And you can see on the bottom it's just going clear where the isopropanol's reacted.
It's not funny. The quenching of it actually is more interesting than the...
Yeah, often the case.
What's going on at the top there with that crusty sort of powderiness?
This white stuff up here, it could be... It's either sodium amide or sodium isopropoxide, which is also a white solid. So that is really quite pretty there.
Squirt.
Yeah, so thanks.
Clear again.
Yeah, that's the way.
Look at that. That is very pretty.
Have a real chance of spreading to other people and to their conversations, and that's just no good. And that would make me feel very guilty.
So these months that you famously spend researching videos,
yes,
are you wanting them to be really correct because you feel this responsibility to make the world a better place, or because you fear hateful comments and criticism? Which is it?
I would say